In this video, we're finishing the solving systems of equations by substitution worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. This is a free worksheet provided by KutaSoftware, and I'll have a link in the description below so you know how to access this. Now we're going to start by picking up where we left off with number 15. However, if you haven't done so already, all likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, so there's a quick reminder to go ahead and do that. Now, for number 15, we're going to take this second equation and put it as y equals some expression. So I'll subtract 5x from both sides in order to isolate that y. So y equals negative 5x minus 13. I'll take that value, or that quantity that's equivalent to y, and plug it in for y in my other equation. So I'll have 6x plus 6 times negative 5x minus 13 equal to negative 6. So now I'm going to need to distribute that 6 to the negative 5x and the 13. So 6x plus 6 times negative 5x is negative 30x, and then 6 times 13 equals 78, and that's going to be subtracted. That's equal to negative 6. So I'll add 78 to both sides, and in that same step, I'm going to be combining my x terms. So 6x plus negative 30x is equal to negative 24x. Negative 78 plus 78 is 0. Negative 6 plus 78 is a positive 72. Now I'll divide both sides by negative 24 to get that x is equal to a negative 3. So knowing that x is negative 3, solving that through my substitution of y, I'll now take that value and plug it in for x in my equation that's equal to y. So I'll have negative 5 times negative 3 minus 13. That's what y is equal to. Negative 5 times negative 3 will be a positive 15, and I'm subtracting 13, which will give me a positive 2. So x is equal to negative 3, and y is equal to positive 2 in number 15. In number 16, I'll be able to write the top equation in terms of y, and I'll do so by subtracting 2x from both sides. So I'll have that y is equal to negative 2x plus 20, and I'll take that value, negative 2x plus 20, and plug it in for y. So 6x minus 5 times negative 2x plus 20 equals 12. Distributing that 5, I'll get 6x plus 10x, since minus 5 times negative 2x will be minus a negative 10x plus 10x, and then minus 5 times 20, which is 100. That's equal to 12. I'll add 100 to both sides to get that 6x plus 10x, which is 16x. That's going to be equal to 112. And when I divide both sides by 16, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 7. Now I'll take that value for x and plug it in to solve for y. So y equals negative 2 times positive 7 plus 20. So that's negative 14 plus 20, which equals a positive 6. So x is 7 and y is 6. That's the solution for this system in number 16. In number 17, I'll solve this second equation in terms of y. So I'll subtract 3x from both sides to get that 3y equals negative 3x minus 3. And then I'll divide everything by 3 to get that a positive y equals negative x minus 1. Since negative 3x divided by 3 is negative 1x, or negative x, and we're subtracting 3 divided by 3, which is 1. Now that I've solved for y, I'll be able to substitute that y in for the y in my other equation. So I'll have negative 3x minus 4 times negative x minus 1. That's equal to a positive 2. So negative 3x plus 4x plus 4 equals 2, because when I distribute that 4 to the negative x and negative 1, and I'm subtracting those quantities, I will be adding 4x and 4. So now I'll subtract 4 from both sides of my equation. So I'll get that negative 3x plus 4x, which is a positive x, is equal to 2 minus 4, which is a negative 2. So knowing that x is negative 2, I'll plug that in for my equation that I solved for y. So y equals the opposite of negative 2 minus 1. So that's positive 2 minus 1, which equals 1. So in number 17, x is negative 2 and y is a positive 1. In number 18, I'll go ahead and solve this first equation in terms of x. So I'll do that by subtracting 6y from both sides. So I'll get that negative 2x equals negative 6y plus a positive 6. And when I divide both sides by negative 2, I'll get that positive x is equal to positive 3y plus a negative 3, or simply minus 3. That's because negative 6y divided by negative 2 is a positive 3y, and 6 divided by negative 2 is a negative 3. So now take that quantity that's equivalent to x and plug it in for x in my other equation. So now I have negative 7 times 3y minus 3 plus 8y equals negative 5. So I substituted x in. Now negative 7, I'll distribute that, so I have negative 21y plus a positive 21 plus 8y equals negative 5. I'll subtract 21 from both sides, and I'll combine my y's on my left, negative 21 and positive 8y. Negative 21y plus positive 8y equals negative 13y, and negative 5 minus 21 is negative 26. So when I divide both sides by negative 13, negative 13 goes into negative 26 evenly, so I'll get that y is equal to a positive 2. Knowing that y equals 2, I'll plug that in and solve for x. So x equals 3 times 2 minus 3, which is 6 minus 3. So x is equal to 3. So 3, 2 is my solution for x and y in number 18. For number 19, I'm going to solve the second equation for x. So I'll start by adding 7y to both sides. So I'll get that positive 2x equals 7y minus 17. And when I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that x is equal to 7 halves times y minus 17 halves. So I'm going to take that quantity of x and plug it in to my first equation. So I'll have negative 5 times 7 halves times y minus 17 halves minus 8y equals a positive 17. So distributing that negative 5, I'll have that negative 35 halves times y minus 17 times negative 5, which is negative 85, so plus 85 halves minus 8y equals 17. So now I'm going to simplify and solve for y. I'll start by subtracting 85 halves from both sides. And at the same time, I'll combine negative 35 halves y and negative 8y. So continuing my work, up near the top, negative 35 halves y plus negative 8y or minus 8y, if we put 8 in terms of halves, that's 16 halves. So if I have negative 35 and I'm taking away 16 more halves, I'll have negative 51 halves times y equal to 17 minus 85 halves, which 17 in terms of halves is 34 halves. And if I have 34 halves and I'm subtracting 85 halves, I'll have negative 51 halves in order to isolate my y. So if I multiply both sides by 2, my 2's will cancel out. And also if I divide both sides by negative 51, my negative 51's will cancel out. So I'll get that y is equal to a positive 1. Now I'll need to plug that value of y in and solve for x. So x equals 7 halves y minus 17 halves. So x equals 7 halves times 1, which is 7 halves minus 17 halves. So x equals negative 10 halves. So x is equal to negative 10 divided by 2, which is negative 5. So my solution at number 19 is negative 5, 1. Negative 5 is x, and 1 is y. Now, if you got confused when I solved for y, going from this step to this step, I did a lot of simplification in my head, but feel free to write out each of your steps. Remember, you can write negative 8 as negative 16 over 2, and you can write 17 as 34 over 2. So now that you have a common denominator, you'll be able to add those fractions or subtract those fractions. Now in number 20, I'll solve for y in this first equation. I'll do so by adding 2x to both sides. So I'll get that negative y is equal to 2x minus 9. However, I don't want that y to be negative, so I'll multiply both sides by negative 1. In turn, I'll get that positive y equals negative 2x plus 9. So I'll take that value of y and plug it in to my other equation. So 5x minus 2 times negative 2x plus 9 equals 18. So that'll be 5x minus 2 times negative 2x, which is minus negative 4x, or plus a positive 4x, and then minus 2 times 9, which is 18. That's equal to 18. Adding 18 to both sides, 5x plus 4x is 9x, and that's equal to 18 plus 18, which is 36. My next step will be to divide by 9 to get that x is equal to a positive 4. Now knowing that x is 4, I'll plug that in and solve for y. So I'll have that y equals negative 2 times 4 plus 9. So that's negative 8 plus 9, which equals a positive 1. So for the last problem on this worksheet, x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 1. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. And if you didn't do so at the beginning of this video, like, subscribe, and share.